But we made another hunt, made two stands out here tonight on the 9,500 acres we've been getting to hunt. And we actually seen a coyote run across the road driving around this evening and couldn't get him to come in. So we went over here by these camps and I think I started out with, what did I start I started with a mouse, and I went to the luscious lips, and then went to the cottontail, and this sucker came from a long ways away. It took 45 minutes to get him to come in. We were almost at the 45 minute mark, and me and Jess are talking on the way here. I think at night we're gonna have to, because a lot of times we'll make a stand for 30 minutes, and then we'll, you know, pack up and go to the next spot. But
just kind of ground.
Yeah, but this is the second coyote that we've killed after the 45 minute mark out here at night. So I think from now on we're going to make it a 45 minute, you know, hunt each time, and see if it doesn't help. So, but that makes two coyotes out here, two fox and a bobcat.
So here,
and we've had opportunities that we didn't make the most of, but just the coyote came out on my side, and Justin, he finally got, what is this, your stamp?
Yeah, so I had to get a tag stamp. I had to wait for it to come in for me to be able to take the silencer home.
Yeah, so he got his silencer in today, and he went and shot it. He actually had to re-zero it. It was off a little bit from adding the can to it. But, yeah, it's freaking awesome. It quietened that gun down a lot. Of course, he's been shooting with the flash hider on there, so it was freaking deafening. But that thing's badass. I mean, he shot. It sounded like about like a 22 mag going off. And there's no doubt if we had some coyotes in the area, I think this was just a lone male. But if we had some coyotes in the area, it was quiet enough that I could have went to a pup distress and got them to come back and maybe get another shot.
So. And that was ultimately what I wanted. We're not running subsonic rounds. It's just the Hornady-vmax, 85 grain. So, I mean, it's just a standard round. So the
vmax we talked about on one of the videos about how we love them so much because they don't mess the pelts up and we get to save a lot of the hides. But I don't think I talked about it on the last. We went to West Texas hill country, mm-hmm. and got to go on a guy's place and shoot some fox. We ended up shooting four gray fox, but we learned that them VMAX are badass. I mean, this coyote's got one little pencil hole in it, no exit hole. But it screwed them fox. I mean, it tore them apart. So, I'd say, you know, for fox or, you know, bobcat, I mean, we killed bobcats with no exit holes too, but I think the distance, because we were shooting some of these fox at probably 50, 60 yards. And,
or even closer than that.
Yeah. Yeah, and there was a, it turned them inside out, so. But, it looks like an adult male. He's definitely starting to lose his coat.
Yeah.
But, we saved a few rabbits today anyway. That's what we're here for, so. Make a showing. Anything about your can?
Well, so silencers from the Silencer Co. They're out of Weatherford, Texas. After I got that tag stamp, I did all my paperwork and stuff, and I've got it back. Man, I'm more than happy with that silencer. I know, it, like you said, it sounds like a 22 magnet. I'm right there at it, so it does sound a little louder to me. But I'm impressed with it. Maybe shot it four times after when I, as soon as I just strut it on, four shot four times or five times, and it was ready to go again. So,
yeah, we're kind of we've been doing a little research, man. I mean, I don't have one. This is just a full rifle length. It's got a it's not even threaded, but I mean, I'm impressed. We're kind of leery about shooting the subsonic rounds. My neighbor is real big into the silencers and all that stuff, and he's got several guns with them on, and he's telling us, and we've also read that the subsonic rounds, it's such a long bullet, you know, to get below the, or right around 1,000 feet per second, that these short-barreled ARs, it just don't stabilize them. He said he hasn't seen one that's been accurate yet.
Right.
So we're gonna. I mean, it's 100 times better than what it was.
Yeah.
And we're really not worried about total silence. We just right. He just wanted to, you know, keep it down, and it does perfect. I mean, you
enough
know,
to where I can get a follow up shot. That's it.
Yeah. There's no doubt in my mind that. You know, like I said, if there was another coyote there, he probably would have, you know, spooked a little bit, but it wouldn't have been like shooting it out of a regular rifle. I mean, it muffled it down enough to where I was standing that, I mean, it didn't even ring my ears or nothing. I mean, it's a good setup. I'm impressed. And, you know, for as much money as we got in our ARs, they're awesome. I changed my bolt carrier group out on this one, and when we went to the hunt, and it was a terrible idea. Don't ever do anything to your gun and go on a hunt and decide you're going to shoot it when you get there.
Yeah.
Because it wouldn't eject my shells. Then it started ejecting my shell. Then it would rack two of them in at the same time. It was a pain in the ass. I ended up having a single shot at the whole entire time we were there. I think I talked about it, but I got the original one back in there, and so we should be good to go now.
And you'll see in that video, man, he had him dead to rights two or three times. I think he just wanted to hear what that silencer sounded like. But.
Yeah, so I had a couple of mishaps. I missed a couple of fox. We both ended up missing a couple of fox. I lost my confidence because that my gun was acting the way it was. And the first fox that come out in daylight, I shot under it, and then just ended up shooting it. And then we went to the next stand and had another fox come out, and I ended up shooting it, making a good shot on it, killing it. But then we went to another spot. We went to by the camp,
and
had one come out. We watched a video on it. It actually, right when I squeezed the trigger, we had this happen to him. He had it happen to him too. But we would get these foxes to stop, and then we would squeeze that trigger, and right when it'd go off, that fox would move. But he ended up getting he ended up shooting a third one, and then the fourth one came out. We actually had three foxes come out that on that
one time.
I told him, I said, Justin, let me get this one, man. I got to get some redemption, or, you know, at least get my confidence back that my gun was acting okay. Because we were going to hunt the next morning. I had zero confidence. We ended up shooting it on paper that night, and it was dead on. But I was having to literally load one shell. I could not put more than one shell in there. So I owed him. I told him, I said, I owe you one for letting me do that. And he actually let me kill a bobcat out here, too. So we watched it. We got probably close to a minute of video of the coyote coming in. Right. So it worked out. He got to shoot his. I mean, he literally put the silencer on today.
Yeah.
So you know, we get new toys. We want to use them right then. We don't have guns that sit in the gun safe. All of our guns have a purpose, and we use them. So.
And this is a big addiction for sure.
Oh yeah. Yep.
It looks like it's about to start raining.
Yep, let's get the heck out of here. We got